thought about the idea of reset. It's like, what are you going to do to reset? First thing is taking a step back and really just taking a deep breath and thinking about how can I incorporate a little bit more self-care to rest and recuperate. Because when you're under chronic stress, whether it's from being a parent of a child who has a lot of trauma or just living in Silicon Valley, it's a very stressful environment that we live in, the pace in this culture that we're living in. And so figuring out how to incorporate more self-care is really good for all of us. The other thing is the T word, trauma. There's all sorts of what people out in the world will describe as trauma. Most of the books that you're going to read on trauma are geared toward eventocentric trauma, which is there was a thing that happened, right? And there are definitely things that happen to children with developmental trauma. But partly what happens is it's the way that their nervous system gets set up to do stress, right? And it's all of our, it's our history, it's our ancestors' history that gets passed down through genes, but then also through the environment that we're in and how our nervous system gets dysregulated. And everybody in this room, including me, has some dysregulation in their nervous system. So I really like that concept because it just changes the wording, nervous system dysregulation. And guess what? We all have it. So it levels the playing field. And I work on mine, and I've made a lot of progress with it, so I can kind of tell you, in a lot of cases, what my experience has been of coming to a more regulated system. Right? So we help each other along.